Today we will see what is caching and why it is used. So the main purpose of using caching in any application is to improve the performance. Improve performance, especially the performance of reading performance. Okay. So how the caching improve the performance? So what will happen when you using any application? It has to do lots of things. Such as network call, okay, API call and calculation. To avoid these things which are done frequently and whose data does not change frequently, we store this data locally to avoid these network call, API call and calculation. This is called caching. So what is caching? Caching means bringing some data at local memory to avoid unnecessary network call, API and calculation is called caching. Why we do it? The main question is why we do it. First thing, it will improve the performance. How? If you avoid unnecessary API call, network call, calculation, then the performance get increased. So that if the performance increase, then throughput also increase. And if everything is present locally, latency also get increased. And if some server or anything go down for a few time, so if the data is present at your local server or your local storage, then availability also improve. So caching help to improve performance, okay, availability, throughput, latency. So where these caching is used? Suppose you are using any application, okay, you have to make lots of network call, API call and calculation like thing. So which the thing which are not changing very frequently, we store these thing locally so that these unnecessary thing calls have not to be making. This by this way performance get increased. And where these data are stored? Suppose you are opening a browser, okay, browser. From browser you are opening any application front end. By this you are going to back end for any type of logic, and logic happen with the help of database, okay. So if there is some data which are frequently used and it does not change, so what will do? What backend will do? It stores some locally some data, so it does not have to make frequently call to the database. And if frontend see that some of the business logic or logic of a application of backend are frequently used, then frontend store this data in them, okay, locally. Similarly, if browser see that something you are used frequently, then browser also store this thing in the form of caching locally. So there are two different way of caching. First one is application server cache. Second one is CDN. CDN means content delivery network. I hope you understand it. Now application server cache means when you are using any application to avoid network call, API call or calculation, what you store in a application locally, that is called application server cache. But when you open any application, you find that some of the data are very static, like the HTML content of any application, CSS or JavaScript. So what will do application store this data locally on a CDN which is provided by third party application CDN. So when any user want this, instead of coming this static from server, it come from the CDN which present nearby you. So by this type of caching is called CDN caching. Okay, so I hope you understand two different thing, CDN and application server caching. Now you ask me, is there any type of caching? Yes, two types of caching. First one is local cache. Second one is distributed cache. What happen in local cache that it store data on your RAM, okay, and it is specific to single machine. When there will be any data which is specific to a single machine, then that cache is called local cache. But there are some data which has to be shared between different machine, that is called distribution cache. Okay, so if you have a different type of machine and you want to share this data, so you use distribution cache. For example, suppose you have any application whose data is stored in a four different machine, and this is your database, and here it is a load balancer. So you come store your premium plan detail or card detail in a server, and if that server stores data in locally here, so what will happen? There will be a big problem. Why? Suppose the second time you come, the load balancer send you to this server, and this server locally does not store your previous detail. So what will happen? Your detail have to fetch from the database, so your performance decrease. So to avoid this condition, you have a distributor cache here which store all the detail of all the four server. So next time when you go to any of the server, you find the detail very fast because of the distribution cache. I hope you understand it. Now you ask the question, if it make anything very fast, performance gets increased, so we have to use it everywhere? No, you do not use cache everywhere. You use cache in only that place where data does not change frequently. Frequently, if data change very frequently, just then you do not use cache, because then every time you have to change the caching detail, because caching this means that something which does not change frequently, you store it so that you have to avoid the network call. But if the data changes frequently, then there is no meaning of having cache. That's the why static content usually stored in cache, because your application HTML content or CSS content or JavaScript content, or if you buy any call detail you store, or if you have any email ID related detail about any application, these type of data does not change frequently, so you store this type of data into the caching. And second thing, caching only help in the reading behavior. So if your application is writing incentive, where you have to write more things than reading, then do not use cache. Caching is better for a reading application like news portal, blogging, or storing any detail which you store only one time or very frequently, very less frequently, and use very frequently. So you are reading the data more time than writing the data. At that case, caching is very helpful. I hope by this example you will understand each and everything about caching. We will meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye.